The National Hot Rod Association has the world's coolest cars. That's what I'm saying, and I think it's true, and I'm about to try to prove it to you. If you've been around the Carolinas for the last 40 years checking out drag strips, there are certain cars that are famous. This is one of them. The Flintstone Super C Modified of Josh and Jimmy Barzi. An amazing car with a small block for power, and its grandson and grandpa and grandson Josh, you got to take over the wheel of this car from your grandfather about 6 years ago. Tell us a little bit about this Flintstone Chevy 2.
It's great. It's been in the family for, like I said, over 40 years. It was an honor to take the wheel over. It's fun. It's got a clutch in it, high RPMs, turning it. It's blast to drive. I mean, it's fun getting to race NHRA races, the gear jammers, you know, and just turn it as hard as we can and letting it go.
Well, people talk about this car. This is a car that people love, that they talk about, and I know people who have told me flat out, like, this car is one of the reasons they got involved in racing because it had so many great moments. So tell me about your grandpa. We're going to let him talk, but I want to hear what you have to say about Jimmy and how he pulled you and so many more people into the sport with this Flintstone Nova.
Oh, Lord, where it starts, I mean, the day he bought this car, he told me he redone the whole thing. He wanted it his way, and that's what he did. And this has been in his life 100% since the day he bought it. Every day, this is what he does. This is what he lives for. This is all him. And he wouldn't trade it for nothing in the world.
Well, let's look under the hood. And Jimmy, of course, tell us a little bit more about that. When did you get this car? Tell me that first experience. Was it at a dealership? Where'd you get it?
In the early 80s. And it was part of a race car then, but I didn't like the way it was, so I just cut it up and made it like I wanted it.
Right away, like you wanted.
Right quick.
Always a clutch car?
Yes, sir. Nothing else but a clutch.
Smart man. So tell me about some of the tracks you've raced around the Carolinas.
We ran Piedmont and Farmington, Mooresville, and Rocksburg, Coastal Plains, all these tracks around North Carolina.
Now, the reputation of the name, where did the name come and how did that develop?
Is a friend of mine always called me Flintstone when I was growing up, and that's what we wanted to put on the car, put Flintstone on the car, because they always call me that.
Cars with names, we always like to say cars with names, they stick out in your mind. You can put it on a t-shirt, you can put it on the car, and everybody knows exactly. In fact, I was like, we got to go talk about that Flintstone car. Superstock, C Modified, that's a pretty radical category.
Yes, sir.
And leaving the starting line, we can tell with this thing.
Yeah, you had to leave about 9,600. Something like that to make it run good, then turn shift about 10,000.
So we're gonna want to see Josh in the cockpit of the car, but before we do that, how's the kid doing?
Doing real good.
Yes.
Since he started, he's doing real good, exceptionally well, really, for a kid that young.
Exactly. And being out here at the NHRA, you know, I'm sure you guys have people that come by that has seen the car.
Yes, sir.
Over the years, what is that experience like when people come up and say, "Hey, man, I was at Piedmont and I saw this car, and I love drag racing."
It's pretty neat to have some people that really like it. You know, a lot of them like a stick car. Most of them like the stick cars better than anything else. That's the main part of, you know, running a car.
Well, all the added driver elements.
Yeah.
No offense to the automatic guys, but no. You're doing less.
Yeah, you
as
just got to stay at it. But you got to keep up with your transmissions and clutches and all that stuff all the time.
Now, was it hard for you to get out of the seat?
A little bit, but I
look at Josh. He's like, yes. What was that like?
It's all right because I promised him I'd let him drive it when he got old enough. And, too, I was getting a little age on me then. It's pretty good to let him do it.
Well, let's see him in the cockpit of this car. And, yes, attention to the Pits fans. Take that mic with you, Josh. Take it with you. We are always asking to hear the car, so we're going to do that as well. But I love super stock cars because they have the interior. They're mandated to have an interior. It's a real car, but with a little bit extra. So, Josh, tell me about being a little kid and dreaming of getting behind the wheel of this car that's now your racing entry.
I can remember when I was little, like 3 years old, going to the shop and legitimately falling asleep in the same seat I'm sitting in right now. And it was just a build-up for 3 years old to a 16-year-old, like, this is going to be me. It's going to be me one day. And he promised me. And the first day I got to drive it, you know, it was a dream come true in a way, you know.
Did he, like, leverage it? Did you have to get good grades or do your homework? Or
we went to Piedmont, and I said, well, we're going to turn it down. And he goes, if I got to turn it down, you don't need to drive it. And it was full speed, turned all the way up. We're going to see what you can do. And I ended up doing good. So now I'm here. 8 years later,
Well, let's turn it up right now, if you don't mind. Let's let the audience hear the Flintstone Chevy 2 legendary around the Carolinas for 40 years. Clutch cars and super stock, grandfathers, grandsons, names on race cars. That's why when you come out to the National Hot Rod Association, you got to come out in the pits. Thank you, gentlemen.
Thank y'all. Appreciate it.
Subscribe now.